Hi everyone, welcome here to St. Joseph Church as we have a little server instruction video. So a little video to help maybe new servers or to refresh our current servers on how to serve. We know we've made a few changes here when we did the sanctuary renovation, so hopefully this kind of sets some clarity and so that everybody's on the same page as to how to serve. Maybe just a couple little things before we get started with the nuts and bolts of serving. And one is just to keep your head on a swivel, right? As you're serving, just simply to pay attention, to know, to make sure you're not forgetting everything, to be able to look at Father. So you're going to keep your head on a swivel, right? Left, right, keep looking at Father. And so that's always something important to do. And then the other thing is the alb length, right? When you put on your alb, you're going to grow throughout the years as you're serving. So we've got Mr. Mosler here to demonstrate the appropriate alb length. So it's just above your shoes. So that's basically, that's where we're doing. So he's even got nice shoes on. It's always good to have some nice shoes on when you're serving. The other thing is roles. So servers have different roles. And so we've actually got these new torches that just came in this week, which is pretty exciting. I don't know what they do, but it's a great demonstration. So the ones with the torches or with the candles are called acolytes, and they sit on that side over there, and they'll be in charge of setting the altar. If there's three servers, so there'll be two acolytes, and then the one person who'll be the crucifer, who carries the cross and is charge of bringing the book. So they'll sit on this side. Now, if we have a fourth server scheduled, that there might be some different things that could happen. So if there's a fourth server, that fourth server, if they're experienced enough, could be the incense. So it'd be everybody would have the same roles, two acolytes, crucifer, and then a thurifer is the one that carries the thurible, which has the incense in it. Or that fourth server could just split up the crucifer's role, right? So we'd have two acolytes, a cross bearer, the crucifer, and then the book bearer. So that's how four servers would work. So today for this demonstration, we're gonna have three servers. So there'll be two, you and your brother are gonna be the acolytes, and then, well, your other brother is going to be the crucifer, carry the cross. And then the very last thing, just a reminder, is what to do with your hands if you're not holding anything. So if you're not holding anything, you're gonna fold your hands nice and high, like straight up. My grandpa, when he was training servers, used to say, imagine that your hands are little candles and you don't wanna drip wax everywhere. So you're not gonna do it like a shark, right? Like that's shark. We're not gonna go sharks. We're gonna keep them upright. And then sometimes servers hold their hands down, right? Around their waist. We're not gonna do that. Or play with the cincture sometimes. Right? That's not going to be what we're doing. So if you're standing and you're not holding anything, you'll hold your hands just like so. If you're sitting, you can just place them in your lap, and that's pretty straightforward. Let me give this back to you. So that's basically the introduction. Hopefully this video is helpful, and look forward to having you serve our Lord at Mass. Thanks for watching.
In the opening procession, if there is incense, the person with the incense, called the thurifer, leads the procession. Then they're followed by the cross, the two acolytes, and then if there are any other servers, they follow behind. And then the lector, if there's a deacon, the deacon. Finally, the priest is at the end of the procession. When you approach the altar, make a simple head bow and enter the sanctuary to the side of the altar that you are sitting. If you aren't carrying anything, for example, if you're the book bearer, genuflect and proceed to your side. The acolytes will put their candles or torches away.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you.
As the Gloria is ending, the book bearer picks up the missal. When the priest says or sings, "Let us pray," bring the book to him, facing him so that he can offer the opening prayer.
Let us pray. O God, when the heart of your Son, wounded by our sins, bestow on us mercy, the boundless treasures of your love, grant, we pray, that in paying him the homage of our devotion, we may also offer worthy reparation. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
After the psalm, as the second reading is beginning, the acolytes can move toward their candles normally found in the sacristy for the gospel procession. Make sure they are lit. When the Alleluia begins, come to either side of the altar. The priest or deacon will elevate the book of the Gospels. When he turns to move toward the ambo, lead him there, standing on either side of the ambo during the Gospel. When he finishes proclaiming the gospel, return your candles to their proper location, and you can be seated for the homily.
We commend our prayer for vocations to you, Father, through the intercession of Mary, our Mother, and the Holy Spirit, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
When the vocations prayer ends, you will begin setting the altar. The book bearer places the missal and its stand on the altar. One of the acolytes sets the chalice on the altar. And as the priest or deacon prepares the altar, you will take the burse and the chalice veil from them, setting it on the credence table. Also, if there is a ciborium of hosts on the credence table, bring it to the priest or the deacon. Once the altar is set, the priest or deacon will move to the front of the sanctuary to receive the bread and wine from the gift bearers. The acolytes will meet him on either side. The bread will need to go up to the altar, the wine to the credence table, and the gift basket to the foot of the altar. Both servers will then go to the credence table. You will take water and wine up to the priest or the deacon. Wait while he prepares the chalice to receive back the wine and the water. After the priest offers the chalice, approach him to wash his hands. One of you will have the water and the dish, while the other one has the towel.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
After the holy, 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 you will kneel with all the congregation. One of the servers will ring the bells. You ring the bells confidently so that people can hear them. At the epiclesis, when the priest puts his hands over the bread and wine, ring the bells once. When the priest elevates the body of Christ, ring the bells three distinct times. Also, when he elevates the chalice, ring the bells three times also. After the great Amen, you will all stand. You'll be standing for the Our Father. After that, during the sign of peace, you can exchange the sign of peace with each other and then with the priests and the deacon. If there are any extra patens or ciboria without hosts, bring them to the altar for the distribution of Holy Communion. After the Lamb of God, you'll kneel again.
Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Then, once the priest receives Holy Communion, you will receive Holy Communion yourselves. After receiving Holy Communion, return to your spot and thank God for the gift of his body and his blood. While Holy Communion is being distributed, the book bearer will remove the missal and the stand from the altar. When both the priest and the deacon finish distributing Holy Communion, there may be some leftover hosts that need to be placed in the tabernacle. After this, you will pour water over the priest's finger to purify them. Keep pouring until he pulls his fingers apart, which is a subtle sign. Another acolyte can bring the burse and the chalice veil back to the altar. As the priest or deacon purifies the vessels and sets them on the side of the altar, remove them and return them to the credence table. The chalice will be the last thing removed. Please use two hands to take the chalice from the altar back to the credence table. When Father finishes purifying the vessels, he'll return to the chair and normally sit. As the priest stands, he'll say or sing, "Let us pray."
Let us pray.
The book bearer can pick up the missal and come forward for the concluding prayer. After this prayer, return the book to the stand. As the priest is praying this prayer, the acolytes pick up their torches, and the crossbearer goes to get the cross.
The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, Father, and Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace.
After Father gives the blessing And as the final hymn begins, the procession forms outside of the sanctuary. The crucifer stands a few feet into the aisle, the acolytes next, and then the bookbearer, if there's a separate one for the bookbearer. Leave room for the priest and deacon, and possibly the lector, to genuflect. Once Father gets to the steps, he will genuflect, and then everyone will turn together to recess out of the church. Hopefully that video on how to serve is helpful for you. And just a couple things for after Mass. You know, there are three things maybe to do. First, to snuff out all the candles, even if the Easter candle's lit, make sure you get that one put out. And then also to clear off the credence table. So the chalices, the patens, the cruets with water and wine, just to take all of that back. And normally it goes near the sink in the sacristy, if there is a sink. And then finally, just to look around the sanctuary. Maybe there's stray pieces of paper or hymnals or maybe some chairs that need to be kind of rearranged. So just to make everything looking nice for the next Mass. And then kind of in line with that, when you're taking off your vestments, your alb, your cincture, please hang them up as nicely as possible so that they are looking in good shape and they don't fall on the ground and there's not any other dirt or kind of clutter that's going to kind of enter into our closets or our sanctuaries. And then probably the best thing to do before you leave is to sit down or kneel down and say a little prayer of thanksgiving to God. Remember, he just invited you to serve at his altar, and it's such a blessing, such a privilege to be so near to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. He just fed you with his very body and blood. And so it's so important after Mass to thank God for this incredible gift and ask him to be your companion, ask him to be your friend, your Lord, as you leave church and go on with your day so that the Lord may always be near you. May God bless you. Thank you for serving at the altar. We look forward to seeing you the next time you get to serve at Holy Mass.